joined by Kevin Feely to look ahead to the Allianz Football League campaign for 2019. So, Kevin, I'm just going to talk to you about Clare there for, and Cullum Collins, Clare, consistent side in Division 2 for the last few years, finished third last year, just missed out on promotion by a point, and Clare, probably the first two games against Cavan and Tipperary, they were leading with 5 or 6 points. Tip caught them in the third minute of injury time, Cavan caught them with a goal with a minute to go. If Clare got one win out of those two games, Clare were promoted. So Cullum Collins, probably one of the longest managers around there, 5 years now. Clare probably consistent, many people would have thought the first 1 or 2 years they go up to Division 2 they'd struggle. They've proven an awful lot of people wrong, and you've had some epic battles with them in Newbridge in an All-Ireland quarter-final, All-Ireland qualifier of Lough and Innes that went down to the wire as well. And what do you make about the Clare challenge? Is it one that she don't take for granted?
Oh, jeez, we have no right to be ever taking Clare for granted. I think of last year, you know, unlucky isn't the word to describe, you know, how unfortunate Clare were not to get out of the division. Like you said, a couple of leads in the first two games that, you know, if they had a head on to it, they would have been more than comfortable getting out of the division. But, we can only speak for our own battles against Clare. And every time we play them, we know it's going to be an absolute battle. And Clare probably, you know, as talented a football team as there will be in Division 2, and I'm sure their goals and aims this year will be very similar to the ones we'd be setting ourselves. You know, they're a hugely talented and athletic outfit, so we certainly wouldn't be taking them for granted. And we know when we play them this year, it'll probably be no different to any of the other games we played them in previously. We'll just hopefully be looking to exact a bit of revenge for their co-park defeat of us in the league final there a couple of years ago.
Yeah, and I suppose, Kevin, you're a midfield man yourself there beside Tommy Mulick, and that's going to be, you must look forward to that midfield jostle every time you meet Clare coming up against Cathal O'Connor and Gary Brennan. Gary and Cathal there will be in the Clare midfield now for over 10 years, probably one of the oldest partnerships outgoing there. They know each other, and yourself and Tommy have a partnership there going back a good few years as well. So that's a one challenge I say that there's no need to get yourself motivated for. It must be one of the midfield combos that you like going up against, because you know you're going to get a fair tussle out of Gary and Cathal.
Yeah, absolutely. I said it last year and the year before that the Clare midfield is up there, one of the best in the country, and there's no doubt about that. They've proven that to everyone who's watched Clare over the last few years that they're right up there. And yeah, I think in any game that we've played against Clare, a lot of the time the battle at midfield has been a huge, you know, determinant of the result. And you know, there's been games where Gary and Cathal have certainly shaded it over myself and Tommy, and then many of the games where we came out on top, we probably had just edged a small advantage, but it's certainly never more than a minimal advantage that either pairing gets over the other. You know, it's always an epic battle. So we'd expect nothing different this year, and we'd have huge respect for what the lads have done for Clare over the last few years.
Yeah, and I suppose, Kevin, I suppose you have been putting a squad there for the past few years together as far as moulding and coming. And how important is it to keep all those pieces of that squad together in relation to that? Kildare would be seen as a county with resources, but I suppose like any county, you always want the best players available to you. And even if one or two were to drop out, Kildare probably wouldn't be wouldn't have the same resources as what Dublin have. In relation to dear McConnelly dropping off the seed, if that player left Kildare, he'd be very hard to replace. And is that a true reflection, even though that you have an awful lot of senior clubs and an awful lot of club football in Kildare, that you have been putting a squad together, and if you were to lose one of those pieces of the squad, it would affect you?
Yeah, it definitely would affect us. I think it is kind of inevitable, though, with the toll that inter-county football takes on people's lives. You always understand that there's going to be, you know, a player who's been going at it for a few years, you know, a few long years, they're always going to want some kind of a break. So I think it is inevitable that you're going to lose one or two players, you know, every year or every couple of years. It's a matter of making sure that you have the plans in place to replace them. And luckily we have a good under 20 side with lads who are there to step up and make that step. So even if we do end up with a couple of lads stepping away this year, we'd like to think that we have enough in reserve with the new lads that have come up that we'll still be able to compete at a relatively high level.
And finally, lastly, Kevin, I suppose the main aim for Kildare is, I would presume, is promotion back to Division 1 and to get back to the Super 8s again. Would that be Kildare's main aim for 2019?
Yeah, I'd say that's it in a nutshell, definitely. Yeah. We'd like to do better in our provincial championship than we did last year, most definitely. Yeah, that alongside with reaching the Super 8s, but first and foremost, our one main focus is for the Division 2. That's definitely the number one focus in the short term.